Hi friends, today I wanted to discuss about the SALT NEET Biology 2018 question paper. As you know that biology questions are 90 in number out of 180 questions. Physics is 45 and chemistry is 45. Totally it is 180 questions. So each correct answer carries 4 marks and negative marking is 1 mark. So let us proceed with the questions for biology that was asked during the 2018 year. If you like this video and you have learned from this video, kindly share it with your friends. We're all locked down at home at present due to the corona infection that is happening. So share it with your friends. Knowledge multiplies when you share it. So like and subscribe for the channel. So let us proceed with the questions. So which of the following is an occupational respiratory disorder? So the answer for this is silicosis. So it is an occupational respiratory disease which is caused by crystalline silica dust. So long exposure can give rise to the inflammation leading to fibrosis and serious lung damage. So it is an occupational respiratory disorder. So wherein crystalline silica dust get accumulated and leads to lung damage because of inflammation that causes fibrosis. So calcium is important in skeletal muscle contraction because it binds to troponin to remove the masking of active sites on actin for myosin. So it binds to troponin to remove the masking of active sites on actin for myosin. So to remove that, there is a binding up of this calcium to troponin. So first one is the right answer. 48. Which of the following gastric cells indirectly help in erythropoiesis? So the parietal cells indirectly help in erythropoiesis. The solution for that is the parietal cells secrete HCl and Casson's intrinsic factor. This factor is required for absorption of vitamin B12. Vitamin B12 is essential for maturation of RBC. So indirectly, parietal cells helps in erythropoiesis, that is formation or maturation of RBC. Match the given items in column 1 with those in column 2 and select the correct option below. So the column 1 is fibrinogen. So fibrinogen brings about blood clotting. Globulin, so it is more of defense mechanism. Albumin, it brings about osmotic balance. So the second one is the answer for this. Fibrinogen brings about blood clotting. So globulin helps in defense mechanism. Immunoglobulin, you can remember those words. Albumin, it brings about the osmotic balance. So the second one, A2, B3 and C1 is the right answer. Which of the following hormones can play a significant role in osteoporosis? So aldosterone and prolactin, parathyroid hormone and prolactin, estrogen and parathyroid hormone, they play a significant role in osteoporosis. So the answer is third one, estrogen and parathyroid hormone. The explanation is estrogen is a female sex hormone that promotes the activity of osteoblasts, the bone producing cells. During menopause, estrogen level decreases so that osteoblasts are not able to produce bone effectively. Parathyroid hormone maintains calcium level in blood. It causes the bones to release their calcium into the blood. So high level of parathormone increases bone dissolution, hence causing osteoporosis. So that is the reason estrogen and parathyroid hormone plays a significant role in osteoporosis. Which of the following is an amino acid derived hormone? So epinephrine is an amino acid derived hormone. Which of the following structures or regions is incorrectly paired with its function. So medulla oblongata controls respiration and cardiovascular reflexes. Correct one. Corpus callosum, bands of fibers connecting left and right cerebral hemispheres. Hypothalamus, production of releasing hormones and regulation of temperature, hunger and thirst. Correct. Limbic system is incorrectly paired. It consists of fiber tracts that interconnect different regions of brain. It controls movement. That is the wrong function of it. So the incorrectly paired is limbic system. So the reason is the limbic system lies on both sides of the thalamus. It includes the hippocampus and the amygdala along with hypothalamus. Primarily, the limbic system is involved with emotions, motivation, learning and memory. That's the reason the limbic system is incorrectly matched there. So 4 is the answer there. The next question is, the transparent lens in the human eye is held in its place by ligaments attached to the ciliary body. So they are held in its place by ligaments attached to the ciliary body is the right answer. Among the following sets of examples for divergent evolution, select the incorrect option. Four limbs of man, bat and cheetah, eyes of octopus, bat and man. So the incorrect option is second one, eye of octopus, bat and man is an incorrect option. In which disease does mosquito transmitted pathogen cause chronic inflammation of lymphatic vessels? It is elephantiasis. The answer is first one, elephantiasis. Which of the following is not an autoimmune disease? So Alzheimer's disease is not an autoimmune disease, whereas psoriasis, vitiligo and rheumatoid arthritis are autoimmune disease. Alzheimer's disease is not an autoimmune disease. Conversion of milk to curd improves its nutritional value by increasing the amount of vitamin B12. So that is the answer, vitamin B12. Which of the following characteristics represent inheritance of blood groups in humans? So they are given dominance, codominance, multiple allele, incomplete dominance, polygenic inheritance. Inheritance of blood groups in humans, it is answer is fourth one, A, that is dominance. There is codominance and multiple allele, all three are involved. So dominance you can notice in A blood group or B blood group, codominance you can notice in AB blood group, multiple alleles, so you can notice that in the blood group itself is a very good example for multiple alleles. So A, B and C are the correct option for it. So fourth one is the right answer, A, B and C. So the reason for it is human blood group is an example of dominance. IA and IB are dominant over IO. Codominance, IA and IB are codominant in respect to each other. Therefore the blood group is AB. Multiple alleles, because inheritance of human blood group is controlled by more than two alleles, that is IA, IB and IO. The similarity of bone structure in the forelimbs of many vertebrates is an example of homology. So homology is origin is same but functions might be different, so we call it as homology. Which of the following animals does not undergo metamorphosis? Among these examples that is given, earthworm is an animal that does not undergo metamorphosis, whereas in starfish, moth and tunicates, they undergo metamorphosis. Change in morphological structure from when compared to an young one and an adult. So you can notice that in starfish, moth and tunicates, earthworm do not exhibit or they do not undergo metamorphosis. Which one of these animals is not a homeotherm, that is warm-blooded animals? So they have given examples, Macropus, Cytacula, Camelus, Chelone. So the animal which is not a homeotherm is say a cytoculum, because it belongs to the class Aves. Macropus and Camelus are mammals. Members of class Aves and Mammalia are homeothermal warm-blooded. Chelon is a reptile, and all reptiles are poikilotherm, cold-blooded. So the answer is chelon. So fourth one, chelon is the answer. So it is not an homeotherm, whereas Macropus, Cytacula and Camelus, they are homeotherms. Chelon, since it belongs to reptiles, it is not a warm-blooded animal, it's a cold-blooded animal. So chelon is the answer. Which of the following features is used to identify a male cockroach from a female cockroach? So the presence of caudal styles is noticed in a male cockroach, and it is absent in female cockroach, that is caudal style. So fourth is the answer. Which of the following organisms are known as chief producers in the oceans? Diatoms are known as the chief producers in the oceans. So chief producers of oceans are diatoms, that perform about 50% photosynthesis. Ciliates differ from all other protozoans in having two types of nuclei, macronucleus and micronucleus. You might have noticed that in case of paramecium. So having two types of nuclei is the right answer. Identify the vertebrate group of animals characterized by crop and gizzard in its digestive system. So this crop and gizzard is noticed in case of birds or aves. So that is the vertebrate group of animal which has crop and gizzard in its digestive system. So third one is the answer. The amnion of mammalian embryo is derived from ectoderm and mesoderm. So the hormones secreted by placenta to maintain pregnancy are, so the humocorionic gonadotropin hormone, human prolactin hormone, progestogens, estrogen. So this is the hormone secreted by the placenta, HCG, HPL, to maintain pregnancy. So these are the hormones that are secreted. So third one is the right option. The contraceptive saline blocks estrogen receptors in the uterus, preventing eggs from getting implanted. So that is the right answer. So it blocks the estrogen receptors in the uterus, the contraceptive saline, whenever it is taken by a woman. So it blocks the estrogen receptors in the uterus and prevents the eggs from getting implanted. So first one is the answer. The difference between spermiogenesis and spermiation is, in spermiogenesis spermatids are formed, while in spermiation spermatozoa are formed. In spermiogenesis spermatozoa are formed, while in spermiation spermatozoa are released from Sertoli cells into the cavity of seminiferous tubules. So the second one is the right answer. So 70th is, in a growing population of a country, pre-reproductive individuals are more than the reproductive individuals. That is what we call it as growing population. The next generation, there will be more reproductive individuals than the post-reproductive individuals. That is why the growing population of a country, pre-reproductive individuals are more than the reproductive individuals. The answer is first one. Match the items given in column 1 with those in column 2 and select the correct option given below. So the column 1, there is eutrophication, sanitary landfill, snow blindness, jhum cultivation. So eutrophication is nutrient enrichment, the sanitary landfill is waste disposal, snow blindness is UV beta radiation, and jhum cultivation is deforestation. So the right answer is third one for this. Eutrophication is nutrient enrichment, sanitary landfill is a waste disposal, snow blindness is UVB radiation, jhum cultivation is deforestation. So the third choice is the right option for it. Nutrient enrichment causes eutrophication in aquatic water body. Sanitary landfill is related with waste disposal, snow blindness is due to UVB radiation, jhum cultivation causes deforestation in Northeast India. Which part of poppy plant is used to obtain the drug smack? So the latex is used to obtain the drug from the poppy plant, which is called as smack. Which one of the following population interactions is widely used in medical science for the production of antibiotics? So amensalism is population interaction which is widely used in medical science for the production of antibiotics. Amensalism. So the second option is the right one. All the following are included in ex situ conservation except the ex situ conservation. So the wildlife safari parks, sea tanks, botanical garden. Sacred groves is not an ex situ conservation. So this is the exception. So the fourth is the answer. Match the column 1 with the column 2 and select the correct option given below. Glycosuria. So what does it? Presence of glucose in urine. Gout. Accumulation of uric acids in joints. So it is the second one is the right answer. Glycosuria, presence of glucose in urine. Gout is accumulation of uric acid in joints. So mass, renal calculi is mass of crystallized salts within the kidney. Glomerular nephritis is inflammation in glomeruli. So third one is the second one is the right option. A is 4, B is 1, C is 2 and D is 3. So second one is the right answer. Match the items given in column 1 with those in column 2 and select the correct option given below. So ultrafiltration. So it takes place in Malpighian corpuscle. Concentration of urine. So it takes place in Henle's loop. Transport of urine. So it is through the ureter. Storage of urine, urinary bladder. So the correct choice of answer is fourth one, A4, B1, C2 and D3. A woman has a X-linked condition on one of her X chromosomes. This chromosome can be inherited by both sons and daughters. The X-linked inheritance is always zigzag pattern of inheritance, whereas Y-linked inheritance, it is always direct inheritance from grandfather, father, son, grandson. So whereas X-linked inheritance is zigzag pattern of inheritance, it's not direct inheritance. Both sons and daughters can get affected by X-linked condition. It is inherited by both sons and daughters. Second one. AGGTAT, CGCAT is a sequence from the coding strand of a gene. What will be the corresponding sequence of the transcribed mRNA? So it is, since it is a sequence from the coding strand, so and always the mRNA is synthesized from the non-coding strand or template strand, what we call it as. So it is, coding strand will have similar pattern in mRNA, except that T will be replaced by U. So AGGU, AUCG, CAU. This is the right answer. Match the items given in column 1 with those in column 2 and select the correct option given below. So proliferative phase is follicular. So you have to match the item given in column 1 and select the correct option given below. So proliferative phase is follicular phase. Then secretory phase is luteal phase. Proliferative phase is follicular phase, secretory phase is luteal phase, Mensuration is breakdown of endometrial lining. So the correct option is third one, A2, B3, C1. According to Hugo D. Rice, the mechanism of evolution is saltation, single large step mutation which leads to formation of new species. We call it as saltation. All of the following are product of an operon except, so the odd one you have to find out here, an operator, promoter and enhancer structural genes. Enhancer is a odd one out, or the exception is enhancer. So third one is the answer. The odd one out is an enhancer, which is third option. Which of the following events does not occur in rough endoplasmic reticulum? So the phospholipid synthesis does not happen in RER or rough endoplasmic reticulum, whereas protein folding, cleavage of signal peptide, protein glycosylation, they all these three occurs in RER, but phospholipid synthesis doesn't occur. Which of the statements is incorrect? So the oxidative phosphorylation takes place in outer mitochondrial membrane is wrong. It takes place in the inner mitochondrial membrane, especially in F1 particles or Racker's particles. Oxidative phosphorylation or electron transport chain or terminal oxidation, it is also called as, it takes place within the inner mitochondrial membrane which has the Racker's particles or F1 particles. So the second one is the incorrect statement, because they have given it as outer, rather it should be inner mitochondrial membrane. Select the incorrect match. So polyethylene chromosomes are found in whose sites of amphibians? So the polyethylene chromosomes are not found in whose sites of amphibians, rather lamb brush chromosomes are found in whose sites of amphibians. So that is the wrong statement is second one. Polyethylene chromosomes are not found in whose sites of amphibians. Which of the following term describe human dentition? Thecodont, diphyodont and heterodont is what is the description of human dentition. Thecodont, because they are found within a cavity, teeth are found a cavity. Diphyodont, because there are two sets of teeth, milk set and permanent set. Heterodont, because there are different structures in the teeth, incisors, canines, premolars and molars. That is why we call it as heterodont. So the fourth one is the right answer for the human dentition. Nasal bodies are mainly composed of free ribosomes and rough endoplasmic reticulum. So second one is the answer. Nasal bodies are tigroids. They are found in the multipolar neuron, cyton part of it. So the granules, we call it as nasal body or tigroids. So you should remember about that. Free ribosomes and rough endoplasmic reticulum. Many ribosomes may associate with a single mRNA to form multiple copies of polypeptides simultaneously. Such strings of ribosomes are termed as polysomes. First one is the right answer. Match the items given in column 1 with those in column 2 and give the correct options. Tricuspid valve. I always remember tricuspid valve as the R square T. R represents right auricle and right ventricle. In between you find tricuspid valve. LB square, I remember it as for bicuspid valve. L square represents left auricle, left ventricle. In between you find bicuspid valve. So remember RT and LB to easily remember without undergoing confusions. So tricuspid valve, it is RT, so it is between right atrium and right ventricle. So A is 3 and B is bicuspid valve is found between left atrium and left ventricle. B is 1. C is semilunar valve is found between right ventricle and pulmonary artery. So the right answer is first one. A is 3, B is 1, C is 2. Match the items given in column 1 with those in column 2. So they have given tidal volume. So fourth one is the answer here. Tidal volume is 500 to 550 ml. So the inspiratory reserve volume is 2500 to 3000 ml. Expiratory reserve volume is 1000 to 1100 ml, and residual volume is, so the fourth one, the second one, that is 1100 to 1200 ml. So tidal volume is 500 to 550 ml, inspiratory reserve volume is 2500 to 3000 ml, expiratory reserve volume is 1000 to 1100 ml, residual volume is 1100 to 1200 ml. So that is the residual volume. So the answer is fourth one. Which of the following options correctly represents the lung condition in asthma and emphysema respectively? So asthma, there is inflammation of bronchioles, and in emphysema there is decreased respiratory surface. So the first one is the right answer. The stage during which separation of the paired homologous chromosomes begins is diploid stage. So where the paired homologous chromosomes, after the crossing over and other things, they are going to separation takes place, that takes place during the diploid stage. So fourth one is the answer. Which of the following is true for nucleolus? So larger nucleoli are present in dividing cells. It is a site for active ribosomal RNA synthesis. So that is the right answer for nucleolus. Nucleolus is a site for active rRNA synthesis or active ribosomal RNA synthesis. So 92nd is second one. Stomatal movement is not affected by oxygen concentration, whereas the other things affected, that is temperature, carbon dioxide concentration and light affects the stomatal movement, but not oxygen concentration. So the answer is oxygen concentration, that is third one. Which among the following is not a prokaryote? Saccharomyces is fungi, Oscillatoria, Nostoc, Mycobacterium. So there is prokaryotes, means they have primitive type of nucleus. So you find it only in Kingdom Monera. So Oscillatoria, blue green algae, Nostoc is also blue green algae, Mycobacterium, these all comes under Kingdom Monera. So they are all prokaryotic organism, whereas Saccharomyces is yeast which comes under Kingdom Mycota or Fungia. So Kingdom Mycota or Fungia is a eukaryotic organism. So the odd one is Saccharomyces. So 94th is, first one is the answer. Which one of the following is not a product of light reaction of photosynthesis? So light reaction of photosynthesis, it has cyclic and non-cyclic photophosphorylation. So you should remember about that. So then there is no formation of NADH is not a product of light reaction of photosynthesis, whereas ATPs are formed, oxygen is formed, NADPH2 is formed, especially in non-cyclic photophosphorylation. NADH is not a product of light reaction of photosynthesis. So fourth one is the odd one out, or it's not a product of light reaction. Stomata in grass leaf are dumbbell shaped. So monopods have dumbbell shaped guard cells, whereas in dicots it is usually kidney shape or reniform shape. So stomata in grass leaf are dumbbell shaped, that is the guard cells are dumbbell shaped. So first one is the right answer. The Golgi complex participates in formation of secretory vesicles. So that is the right answer, formation of secretory vesicles. The two functional groups characteristics of sugar are carbonyl and hydroxyl, are two functional groups which are characteristic of sugars. A new variety of rice was patented by a foreign company, though such varieties have been present in India for a long time. This is related to basmati rice, and Indian government had to fight tooth and nail to get this patent, avoid the company from getting patent for basmati rice. So this is related to basmati rice. Select the correct match. So we have to select the correct match. Ribozyme, it has nucleic acid. The G-Mendel transformation is wrong. TH Morgan transduction is wrong. F2 into recessive parent dihedric cross. No, it is wrong. It is rather test cross. So that is what you have to remember about. So the right answer is ribozyme is RNA enzyme that is nucleic acid. So ribozyme is a nucleic acid is the correct match. Which of the following is commonly used as a vector for introducing a DNA fragment in human lymphocytes? So it is in human lymphocytes we are talking about. Here we are not going to use plasmids, rather we are going to use the retrovirus to introduce DNA fragment in human lymphocytes. So retrovirus is used as a vector. In India, the organization responsible for assessing the safety of introducing genetically modified organisms for public use is, so Genetic Engineering Appraisal Committee, GEAC, is the Indian organization responsible for assessing the safety of introducing genetically modified organisms. So GEAC is the answer. The correct order of steps in polymerase chain reaction, PCR, is second one, denaturation, DAE, you can remember it as DAE, denaturation, annealing and extension are the correct sequence of steps in PCR, polymerase chain reaction, which brings about amplification of DNA or RNA. Use of bioresources by multinational companies and organizations without authorization from the concerned country and its people is called as biopiracy. The definition is biopiracy. Winged pollen grains are present in Pinus. So yellow colored winged pollen grains are found in Pinus, and this is called as sulfur shower. So once they are producing the pollen grains, it could be yellow color winged pollen grains. So they are called as sulfur shower. After karyogamy, that is fusion of nucleus, followed by meiosis, spores are produced exogenously in agaricus. So there is four classes that you have to remember in fungi. So you remember about the deuteromycetes or fungi imperfecti. So then you have the zygomycetes, ascomycetes, basidiomycetes. Basidiomycetes, you have this agaricus bisporus, that is the mushroom. So agaricus belongs to basidiomycetes, and there you find that the after karyogamy followed by meiosis, spores are produced exogenously in agaricus bisporus. So three is the answer. In members of basidiomycetes like agaricus, basidiospores are exogenously formed meiosis. It's a characteristic feature of basidiomycetes. Which one is wrongly matched? So uniflagellate gametes, polysiphonia is a wrongly matched option. In polysiphonia, the motile stage presence of flagella is absent in any part of life cycle. So there is no flagella at all. Match the items given in column 1 with those of column 2 and select the correct option. Herbarium is herbarium. So you can the herbarium, it is a place where dried and pressed plant specimens are mounted on sheets are kept. So these are herbariums. Key. So it is a booklet containing a list of characters and their alternates which are helpful in identification of various taxa. So key is 4. Then C is museum, it is a place of 1. And catalog, a list that enumerates methodologically all the species found in an area with brief description aiding identification, we call it as catalog. So the second one is the right answer. A is 3, B is 4, C is 1, D is 2. What is the role of NAD plus in cellular respiration? It functions as an enzyme. It is the final electron acceptor for anaerobic respiration. It is a nucleotide source for ATP synthesis. It functions as an electron carrier. Yes, NAD plus functions as an electron carrier is the right answer. So fourth one is the right answer. Oxygen is not produced during photosynthesis by which one among them? Green sulfur bacteria. So they do not. So in green sulfur bacteria, photolysis of water is absent along with the absence of PS2. Therefore, oxygen will not be released in green sulfur bacteria. So oxygen is not produced, which takes place in the non-cyclic photophosphorylation, which should have both photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. Photosystem 2 itself is absent in green sulfur bacteria, so there is no possibility of ZMN cycle that might take place, Z cycle, Z scheme, it might not happen, and there is no photolysis of water in green sulfur bacteria. So the first one is a right answer. Double fertilization is syngamy and triple fusion, that is fusion of the sperm cell with the egg cell, we call it as syngamy, and fusion of sperm cell with the polar nuclei, we call it as triple fusion. After syngamy, there is a formation of embryo, and after triple fusion, there is a formation of primary endosperm nucleus, which later forms the endosperm. So second one is the right answer. In which one of the following forms is iron absorbed by plants? So ferric form of iron is going to absorb, is being absorbed by plants in ferric form and not in ferrous. It is in ferric form the iron is absorbed. Which of the following elements is responsible for maintaining turgor or turgidity in cells? Potassium is responsible for maintaining turgidity in cells. So third one is the answer. Which one of the following plants shows a very close relationship with a species of moth where none of the two can complete its life cycle without the other? So yucca is what you have to remember. In yucca, the pollination is performed by a moth, Pronuba yuccacilla. It is an example of mutualism where both the species gets benefited from each other. So yucca is the plant, and Pronuba yuccacilla is the name of the moth. Pollen grains can be stored for several years in liquid nitrogen having a temperature of -196°C. So this is nothing but cryopreservation. Liquid nitrogen will be there at -196°C. Nishay is the functional role played by the organism where it lives. So we call it as nishay. So which one of the following is a secondary pollutant? So the secondary pollutant is O3. That is, ozone is a secondary pollutant. World Ozone Day is celebrated on 16th September. World Ozone Day is celebrated on 16th September. 5th June is World Environment Day. 16th September is the World Ozone Day. In stratosphere, which of the following elements acts as a catalyst in degradation of ozone and release of molecular oxygen? So chlorine, it plays a role as a catalyst in degradation of ozone and release of molecular oxygen. So chlorofluorocarbons, the CFC. So the chlorine part of that chlorofluorocarbons, they bring about degradation of ozone and it will be a release of molecular oxygen. That is, O3 is broken down to release molecular oxygen. What type of ecological pyramid would be obtained with the following data? Secondary consumer is having 120 grams. Then primary consumer is having 60 grams. Primary producer is 10 grams. So what is the type of ecological pyramid. So primary producer is less, primary consumer is higher than the primary producer, secondary consumer is higher than the primary consumer. So it is an inverted pyramid of biomass. Let us see, the first one is the right answer. So you can notice here 10 grams of phytoplankton, 60 grams of zooplanktons, 120 grams of small fishes. It is an example of pyramid of biomass in pond ecosystem, which is inverted because the biomass of primary producers is lesser than primary consumers. Primary consumers' biomass is lesser than the secondary consumers. Natality refers to birth rate. So fourth one is answer. Which of the following has proved helpful in preserving pollen has fossils? Sporopollenin, the chemical substance, has proved very helpful in preserving pollen as fossils. Which of the following pairs is wrongly matched? So starch synthesis in pea is multiple alleles is a wrongly matched one, whereas all the others are correctly matched. D.H. Morgan linkage, XO type of sex determination is noticed in grasshopper. ABO blood group shows co-dominance, especially AB blood group. So all these are right. Starch synthesis in pea is not an example for multiple alleles. That is a wrongly matched pair. So first one is the answer. Select the correct match. So they have given Alec Jeffries, Streptococcus pneumoniae. Alec Jeffries is one who put forth DNA fingerprinting. Francois, Jacob and Monod. So Matthew Meselson and Stahl, Pison Sakayum, that is wrong. So the semi-conservative mode of replication you can remember about. Alfred Hershey and Martha Chase. So the correct match is Jacob and Monod put forth the lac operon concept. So Francois, Jacob and Jacques Monod. So lac operon concept, so that is the correct answer. Which of the following flowers only once in its lifetime? Bamboo species. So they are called as monocarpic plants because they flower only once in their lifetime. Select the correct statement. So we have four statements, we have to select the correct one. Franklin Schnell coined the term linkage wrong. Transduction was discovered by S. Altman wrong. Spliceosomes take part in translation wrong. Punnett square was developed by a British scientist, that is the right statement. Offsets are produced by meiotic divisions, parthenogenesis, parthenocarpy, mitotic division. So the offsets are produced by mitotic divisions because they are vegetative structures, especially in eicornea you can notice this offsets, which helps in vegetative propagation. They are formed by mitotic cell division. So fourth one is the right answer. The experimental proof for semi-conservative replication of DNA was first shown in a bacterium. So this semi-conservative mode of replication was shown in a bacterium. The wrong statement we have to select in the next one. Cell wall is present in members of fungi and plantae. Yes, fungi, it is made up of chitin, and in plants it is made up of cellulose. Mitochondria are the powerhouse of the cell in all kingdoms except Monera. That is also a right statement. Pseudopodia are locomotory and feeding structure in sporozoans. It's a wrong statement. Sporozoans includes example of Plasmodium vivax. Sporozoan is a type of non-motile protozoan. So example is Plasmodium vivax, which causes malaria. So there is no pseudopodia here. So the mastigophora, or where you have this amoeba and entamoeba, they exhibit pseudopodia, not the sporozoans. Sporozoans are non-motile protozoans. So they don't have any locomotory structures, neither true one or false one. So the third one is the wrong statement. That is the answer. Casparian strips occurs in endodermis. So Casparian strips are found at radial and tangential wall of endodermis. They are made up of suberin, which are hydrophobic in nature. Which of the following statements is Correct. Ovules are not enclosed by ovary wall in gymnosperm. That's the reason gymnosperms are naked seeded plants, we call them as. They don't have seed enclosed by fruit because of absence of ovary wall. So that, this is the correct statement. First one is the correct statement. Pneumatophores occurs in halophytes. So the halophytes you find the pneumatophores or breathing roots. Sweet potato is a modified adventitious root. Potato is a undergone stem modification, but sweet potato, seedlings, it is a modified adventitious root. Secondary xylem and phloem in dicot stem are produced by vascular cambia. Plants having little or no secondary growth are first one grasses. So cycads, conifers, deciduous angiosperms, they have secondary growth. Grasses, they never exhibit, or even if they exhibit, it is very little secondary growth. So the answer is grasses, monocots especially. The first one is the answer. So that completes our all our questions concerned with the 2018 NEET biology question paper. Overall, when I analyze the question paper, this was much more easier than the 2019 question paper. I could notice that more of match the following questions were there and lesser statement questions were there, whereas in the 2019 I could notice equal distribution of variety of questions. So in case if you have benefited by this video, kindly share it with your friends and like and subscribe for this channel also. Best wishes for your upcoming NEET examinations. I'm wishing you an academic success. Thank you.